So morning everyone. Today I would like to introduce Dr. Dayanand Sagar, a 35-year-old pediatrician, practicing pediatrician from Warangal. He last 35 days he undergone lot of stressful and hard journey with COVID positive condition. We will ask about his feeling, how he is feeling coming out of 18 days of ventilator and 12 days of ECMO, and he is first patient from South India, COVID positive, and came out of ECMO successfully. And then the treating consultant, Dr. Pawan Kumar Reddy, he is with us. He is chief of critical care services in Care Hospitals Banjara Hills. Along with me, my colleague Dr. Parbeen, she is a medical superintendent in Care Hospitals Banjara Hills. Dr. Dayanand Sagar, 35-year-old pediatrician, very lovable pediatrician in the locality, and he is very active doctor in IMA. He is very enthusiastic and energetic, always standing in the front to serve the society. So now we will ask Dr. Dayanand Sagar about his feelings last 35 days, how his journey.
First of all, I thank God and well-wishers of my health and Pawan Kumar Reddy sir and Care Banjara intensive care team, because I didn't have any hopes after a few days of ventilation. Initially, deep sedation, but after a few days of ventilation, in between, I came out of sedation. I knew my condition was worsening. I didn't have any hopes. And after a few days, I came out of ECMO. Then I came out of sedation. Then I knew I came out of death because of Care Banjara, especially Dr. Pawan Kumar Reddy sir. I unable to express my gratitude. I just bowed down, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you very much. And I especially thank my friends, especially Dr. Pawan and Dr. Mahendra, because I came here because Pawan is here. I'm unable to express my gratitude in words. So just that way I bowed down. Okay. And especially Care Banjara, super. Okay. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Thank you for intensive care. Okay. And thank you for having Pawan Kumar Reddy sir here. Thank you.
So Dr. Dayanand, Dr. Pawan Kumar Reddy is a rock star for us. Like his academic skills and his team building skills, managing the team, and then managing emotions of the patient's family members. It's extraordinary. Last 5 months I am observing him. I don't know when he is sleeping. 1 o'clock you send a message, you send report, you will get a reply. 4 o'clock you send a CT scan report, you will get a reply. Anytime he is there for the patients. These are the qualities making him as a leader, now national leader in critical care services. If you observe the outcomes in Care Hospitals Banjara Hills, almost you are the 75th patient who comes out of ventilator. Probably this is the national record. This many patients from one institute ventilator coming out, this is the national record, all because of the team effort by Dr. Pawan and his critical care team. Like each and every ventilator patients, at least 3 nurses, 2 doctors, round the clock, you have to be with the patient and observe the ventilator settings, observe the monitors, then only these kind of outcomes are possible. So we will ask Dr. Pawan Kumar about the clinical journey last 35 years about Dayanand Sagar's clinical journey. Dr. Pawan.
Thank you, Dr. Riaz. I think I should congratulate. Ultimately, we have a friend with us. It's been an emotional journey, I would say, roller coaster, because we were all emotionally connected. Pawan from the emergency HOD, Pawan, and my team member, Dr. Mahinder, they're all close friends in MBBS, and then they left no stone unturned to make sure that he comes out. I think we have been doing ECMO before also. We have done up to 10 successful ECMOs till now. We have earlier in swine flu situation and others, especially what I'm talking about is only pulmonary causes. Apart from that, we have so many ECMOs we have done for cardiac cases. We did lung heart transplants in our institute. We have done LVADs in our institute. So we have used ECMO there also. So we used ECMO quite a lot of time. But I think COVID itself provides a bigger challenge. Putting ECMO on a COVID patient again has got its own merits and demerits. Especially we realize that ECMO should be put as early as possible to provide a meaningful recovery, because the lung takes time to heal, and the more you use ventilator on a very high settings and support, you'll get a lot of injury in the lung, and then recovery is difficult because the ventilator itself using at high settings causes lung injury. So the earlier you put on ECMO, it is better. Here we had a skepticism again because it was already 18 days that he was on ventilator. In the middle, we actually stopped sedation. We did tracheostomy and he was wide awake. He was chatting on its WhatsApp with his friends with a ventilator connected, but he was still requiring 80% oxygen at that point of time. So we're a little concerned how we are going to go for. But then we had no other option at one point. His oxygen dropped significantly. Then we had to take a call and then go on ECMO. The problem with ECMO, going on ECMO, is ECMO will keep you alive. But to come out of ECMO again, you need the lung to recover ultimately. That's when you take out ECMO. So here, because 18 days were already elapsed, and then we didn't know when that time will come, how long to go on ECMO. So, but still we said, because he's a young chap, we should give all the best to him. We knew it. A lot of emotional connect was there. So we went and said, no, we should do it. We will do all our best to get him out. So I think that emotional bond, and probably he believes a lot in his guru. So I think all those things, spiritual things, sometimes help you coast across these kind of hardships. I think, the team, I have a dedicated team. All the doctors, nurses, my consultants, we have 8 consultants. We have the fellows, residents in the Department of Critical Care. They have been working for the past, not just in COVID, we have been delivering the same sort of results every time, but we never push them out. We don't publicize them most of the times. Here now also, Dr. Riaz, and because we got a lot of feedback, people were asking about it, so we are doing this. Otherwise, we wouldn't routinely do these kind of things. We do the same work. There's nothing new for us. This is the same work we have been doing. But I think in COVID time, we were the first to get prepared. I should thank my administration. They have been at the back of me like a rock. When there was a lockdown announced, even before the lockdown, we had preparations. My administration, I said, I want PPE even during the initial days of lockdown. When everything was locked down, they brought me. I said 10,000 PPE. They got it the next day. And that sort of a conviction when your hospital administration shows, they never pressurize us in anything. On the contrary, they will ask us, what do you want, doctor? How do you want to get it out? So I think that is the sort of, and they give us the liberty, and that's how they have, I think they have seen the results now coming out. They've given me a free hand in managing COVID and setting up protocols, setting up management, the whole system, the hospital itself. Even today, any patient needs to be in the ICU, it has to go through me. So that's sort of a responsibility and power, that, or you can say power or responsibility or leadership attributes that they have provided me. So I think I personally think that it's only possible at CARE, and I've worked in other institutes, I know that. So CARE per se has been standing behind the doctors to provide these kind of achievements. Every department is doing their own work. Now it's the time of COVID, our hard work is coming to the fore. So I think that's the only thing. As far as ECMO is concerned, yes, we have done ECMOs before, but always, every patient recovery is something sweet to us. Every patient whom we lose, again, it teaches us something else. So there's always a sorrow, there's a grief, but at the same time, there's also a joy, every patient who comes out. Here it's a little more sweet because he's a friend, he's a colleague. He's a doctor who's going to go back to society and then be a very productive member of the society. So a lot of children would benefit from him. Again, he's a pediatrician. He's a very well-loved pediatrician. I don't know how many calls I had to take. All my friends had to take. All my teammates had to take, because there are so many well-wishers who have been asking for his status updates. And I should also appreciate the way his brother stood by and through the time, through the thick and thin. I think that's from me.
Thank you, Dr. Pawan, for nice words. We in care hospitals, we believe in culture of patient first. Patient first, we don't think about any other, like, so patient socioeconomic condition or patient details, where he is from, what kind of background, we don't think about. We think only, like, how can we make a bonding with the patient and family members to bring the best possible outcomes. This culture is making our institution unique in getting these outcomes, whether it is ECMO or ventilators or other specialties like cardiology, neurology, neurosurgery, liver transplants, kidney transplants, LVADs, heart transplants, deep brain stimulus. These are the unique services we are offering with the culture of patient first. So here my colleague Dr. Parveen will say a few words about Dr. Dayanand Sagar. She was with the team day in, day out, and discussing about the clinical journey of Dr. Dayanand Sagar. Dr. Parveen.
First of all, I would like to congratulate Dr. Dayanand and also Dr. Pawan for such a good success stories. I know this pandemic and in this crisis, it's not easy for the frontline warriors also, because they also need to go back home and they also need to take care of their families. So in this crisis also, I'm very happy that in the care, all the frontline warriors stood together for the most, and we know that there'll be more success stories coming up. So congratulations once again, Dr. Dayanand.
So lastly, I appreciate all our doctors, nurses, frontline workers, housekeeping, everyone. We are all working as a team in this pandemic situation. How can we contribute for the society in best possible way? Thank you. Thanks for all of you. Thanks for your support. And once again, I congratulate Dayanand Sagar, and I thank all the clinical team and then nursing team. Thank you very much.